Good morning, thank you for inviting me to this very interesting conference. I will describe the Venice Lagoon tidal inlet transformation over the century. In the beginning, during the first 4,000 years, the inhabitants took peace with the fluctuation of man's sea level, and we can find different settlements from Neolithic to Mesolithic to the Bronze Age that can show this change in location of this settler. But in 1360, a committee was organized in order to solve this terrible problem of siltation of the tidal inlet of the inlet of Lido, the one that was bringing to Venice. Here you can see the gap with the fortress. And these wise men and practitioners together started thinking what to do. They relied on their experience about combing the wall, and as the comb is combing the wall, so this groin, using the velocity, will comb the sand out of the navigation channel. The name is Garzina, that is the Italian for cardo, that is the flour that is used all over the world in the Middle Age to comb the wool. Here you can see the success of this first intervention with the separation of these channels with this other, and this intersection was the main cause of siltation. The intervention was also reported historically 500 years later when they were started thinking about how to solve the siltation in a final way. And the solution was to install the 3 km long inlet breakwater in 1901. Now, in 2005, thanks to the inlet breakwater, it was possible to start constructing the storm surge barrier of Mose that was completed in 2013 together with an outer breakwater to reduce the incoming waves that can produce resonance into the barrier. So now this initial breakwater plus this final outer breakwater provide the full possibility to save Venice from flooding using the storm surge barriers. There are plenty of evidence of what I've told you in the historical map, and the first official bathymetric survey started in 1840, 1810 by the Denet, a general of the Napoleon army that was in charge of building the first topographic map of northern Italy. Because of relative sea level rise due to the sinking of the land, due to the destruction of the water and the global sea level rise, at a certain point, for the Venetian, it was impossible to adapt to this variation, and the only solution was to install mobile barrier at the three inlets for a total span of 1.5 km, 78 gates, 4 channels, with different depths ranging from -14 in the navigation channel of Malamocco to -6.5 to the northern entrance of Treporti. The barrier has been effective in stopping the storm during the last winter months from October to December 2020, and there are possibilities to use them to improve water quality inside the lagoon as well as reduce the sediment loss of the lagoon. In 1875 in Chioggia, it was rather evident that the siltation and the formation of shoals at the entrance of the lagoon was causing terrible problems and the risk of shipwreck. The The mathematician made a pledge asking for rapid intervention because it is not conceivable that the people that strive for earning their living under the risk in the open sea then die just in front of the house. With this argument, 40 years later, the inlet breakwater were first in place in 1930. 20 years later, you can see the impact of this inlet breakwater, the formation of a deep canal with a depth of 9 meters, instead before there was only a few meters and very difficult to align for entering, plus a pocket of sand that is now a European protected area for birds, Caroman. Why this resulted in a win-win situation between human and nature? I call this a wise co-evolution because the intervention provides plenty of space and time for nature to adapt. The biodiversity has increased, have been increased, and also the ecological service that we can receive from this human intervention. But there are problems in the Venice Lagoon. The main problem is the erosion of the tidal flat. And the discussion is still open, even though I will bring you the evidence that the main problem, that the main trigger of erosion of 2 million cubic meters per year by the from the tidal flat and the transportation of this resuspended sediment to the canal and into the open sea, as you can see here, is the relative sea level rise over the last century, mainly from 1950 to 1970, over which the pumping of water from the ground was more intense. Now it's not possible to pump water in the Venice region. The erosion was very critical, as you can see, after 1930, and the depth of the tidal flat went from 60 centimeter to 90, and now 1.5 meters as an average. From mathematical models, it can be predicted that the final depth will be stabilized around at minus 2 meters. There are different ideas about the main trigger. Someone says the fishing with the mechanical dredger is the cause, as you can see from satellite picture showing different spots of resuspension. Professor Dal Paus from the University of Padova claim the maintenance of the harbor with the dredging of deep channels and their maintenance, together with the local transportation system, is providing this excess of energy and trapping capability that can sequester the sediment and install a net transport from the tidal flat into the canal. Also, the Professor Dal Paus added the impact of inlet breakwater that are producing a momentum of sediment from the lagoon to the sea that limit the possibility to trapping again the sediment in the following tidal cycle. This last argument has been discussed 20 years ago when the final decision about the storm surge barrier was taken. On that occasion, Professor Seminara demonstrated that even in natural tidal inlet, the flow is not symmetrical, and this is due mainly to the non-linearity of the motion in shallow waters, and to the even though the shape of can be bended or with more with less carrying capacity. The velocity is still very high, and the equilibrium, it is the equilibrium velocity of the sediment on the bottom, and there is a very little differences from a tidal inlet that is armored with lateral inlet breakwaters and the natural tidal inlet made of homogeneous sand, if the bottom, of course, is left unprotected, so can erode according to the current. The traffic and the fishing are causing limited effect to the place in which the action is taking place. Instead, the sea level rise is impacting all over the lagoon. Because the wave height goes with the third power of the water depth, this is a self-amplification system that can produce very rapid erosion, and the more the lagoon is eroded, the deeper it becomes, and then the higher the waves, and the system become completely unstable. That's why Venice Lagoon in the past was dying in the mud, and now is dying in turbulent waters. Thank you.